principles of inheritance and variation. In this chapter we are studying about Mendel's experiments. So before going to Mendel's experiments, what actually he has done, we are to study about certain terms related to the experiments. So after which we will follow what actually Mendel has done, or what the experiments are to be conducted in that pea plant. Now variation means actually it is a common word which we call it as difference. So the degree by which the progeny differ from the parents, so that means the generation which is produced by the parents, so that generation or offsprings or the progeny, it is having certain differences between the parents. So that is called as variations. So our characters, which we differ from our father and mother, it is variation. We are not exactly resembling the same. So that is variation. Then alleles. Allele means it is a pair of contrasting characters. So genes which are coding for the pair of contrasting characters, traits. So traits are characters. So factors, actually Mendel used the word factors. So the word factors are changed as the genes of today. So this contrasting characters which are selected by Mendel, they are called as alleles. So Mendel actually selected 7 pairs of contrasting characters. For example, height character, for height character, there were 2 expressions. So contrasting characters means the character which is having 2 expressions, opposite expressions. So Mendel considered 7 pairs. So height character, tall and dwarf, it is a contrasting character. So there are factors, there are genes which code for or to that express for the pair of contrasting characters, that is called as allele. So the word allele is used for a pair of contrasting characters which were selected by Mendel, and that is the meaning of allele. And usually they are the different forms of the same gene. So that means height, it is a gene. Tall and dwarf, so they are different forms. So gene is the same, so that gene may express either tallness or it may express dwarfness. So that is why allele is a slightly different from forms of the same gene. Then homozygous and heterozygous, these two are related. Now homozygous means now whenever an allele, a pair of contrasting characters, so when the pair of contrasting characters, that means the factors, when they are same, it is called as homozygous. For example, tall character, when it is controlled by similar factors or same genes, like capital T, small t, dwarf character, so it is called as homozygous. So a plant which is having similar factors or similar genes for a character is called as homozygous. It may be either dominant or recessive. So irrespective of the dominance, this homozygous is considered. But however, the pair or the factors should be similar or identical. Now heterozygous means opposite to that. When the factors are not identical, not similar, so when the capital T and capital T are present, homozygous. Suppose when capital T and small t is present, it is heterozygous. Now however, in case of heterozygous also, one of the factor will express its character. For example, in heterozygous, capital T, small t. That means capital T for tall, small t for dwarf. Now both characters are present in that plant. But however, capital T only will express and that plant will be tall, because capital T is the dominant over small t. And that is why usually in the heterozygous conditions, one of the factor will be hidden, or it will be recessive, or it will be suppressed, in other words, and that is why that is called as heterozygous. But in homozygous, both are similar, so there is no question of suppression or recessiveness. So this is what is heterozygous. Then phenotype and genotype, these two are similar terms which are usually asked together for 2 marks like that. Similarly, homozygous and heterozygous are asked for 2 marks. Phenotype means it is the external expression, the outward character, the morphological expression of a plant or of a character in a plant. So what character we see outward or the external expression, that is called as the phenotype. So in any individual, he may be having various characters in his body, but certain characters he will express. It may be artificially or whatever it is. So the outward expression, the external expression which is expressed in an organism, in a plant or in any organism, that is called as phenotype. But genotype means it is actually the genetic content inside the plant or organism. So that is the genotype. Now for example, capital T small t, if you take it is tall plant, but though it is a tall, it is having capital T and small t dwarf character, dwarf factor. That means genotype it is a tall and a dwarf, but phenotype it is tall. So capital T small t is a plant which is phenotypically tall and genotypically dwarf and tall. That is what actually the genetic content or the genetic constitution, the internal character we can say, or the innate character also we can refer. So that is the genotype of an organism. Now Punnett square or checkerboard, it is also referred as, so named after R.C. Punnett, Reginald Punnett. What actually he has done is, Mendel, when he conducted the monohybrid and dihybrid crosser, the F2 generation what he obtained, he had written the genotypes in different ways, almost in an irregular manner. That means when we see that cross, we could not easily follow which are the genotypes of the F2 generation. But Punnett devised a method, or he obtained a method by graphical representation, by writing the genotypes of the offspring in a genetic cross, usually in the F2 generation, and genotypes which are calculated and written. So that is called as the checkerboard. It is in the form of a table, tabular column, and that is Punnett square or checkerboard. So it is a method of obtaining, it is a method of writing the combinations, the genotypes of the F2 generation in a monohybrid and dihybrid cross. So that is Punnett square. Then law of dominance, which is also called as the first law of inheritance. Now first law of inheritance, this is also deals with the experiments conducted by Mendel. So when Mendel crossed the two contrasting characters, take for example tall and dwarf, the F1 generation, the monohybrid which is called as, it produced only tall plants. That means one of the parental character expressed in the F1 generation. So plant tall and dwarf are crossed, but we did not obtain any other character other than the parental character. Only one of the parental character expressed in the F1 generation, the other parental character did not express. So this is actually with referred to the law of dominance. Means when the two contrasting characters are crossed, are brought together in a hybrid, one of the parental character expresses in the F1 generation, and that is called as the dominant character. The other character, other parental character, which do not express in the F1 generation, is called as the recessive factor or the recessive character. So that is the law of dominance. So that means out of the contrasting characters, out of the two contrasting characters, one of the character is a dominant and that expresses in the F1 generation. the other character does not express us, it is the recessive character. This is what the law of dominance states. So this is the one which is related to the both dihybrid and monohybrid cross. Then test cross. After conducting the monohybrid cross and the dihybrid cross by Mendel, the F1 obtained were dominant, but the F1 had both the factors of the dominant and recessive factors. So both the dominant and recessive factors were present in the F1 hybrid, either in the both monohybrid and dihybrid cross. So when these were present, that means it is heterozygous. Now to test this heterozygous nature, or to identify the genotypes of the F1 hybrid, so Mendel to confirm that heterozygous nature, or to confirm the heterozygous nature or the genotypes of the F1 hybrid, he conducted this cross called as a test cross. He conducted this cross by taking the F1 hybrid and crossing with its recessive parent. For example, Tall and Doff, when they are crossed, Tall is obtained. So this F1 Tall was crossed back to the recessive parent, Doff parent. So that is called as the test cross. So when we cross this way, we call it as a test cross. By doing this, by performing this cross, we can identify, we can find out the genotypes of the F1 hybrid and confirm whether it is heterozygous or not. That is the test cross. So the ratio which is obtained, now when we cross the F1 hybrid and recessive parent, the ratio what is obtained is equal. That means 50% will be Tall and 50% will be Doff. So that will be the ratio of 1:1, which is called as the test cross ratio. So the test cross ratio is 1:1. So that is about the test cross which was performed by Mendel in both dihybrid and monohybrid cross. So thank you.